Well, there's no scarcity value in a Merseyside derby. This, the third in 11 days, the 21st in 5 years. But in every other sense, the commodity is exceptional in its appeal. Whatever the context, Everton against Liverpool produces the right kind of footballing passion. And long-time observers of these special occasions have been telling us when we arrived in the area that they can't recall such an interest as there is for this fifth round FA Cup replay. And with each team losing a key player with injury on Sunday, the deliberations of the two managers over selection are of particular interest. Well, here is Howard Kendall's side. Neville Southall, the first name on the team sheet in more ways than one. Then the Dutchman, Ray Atterbeld, wearing number two. Andy Hinchcliffe is back after injury, but a little short on recent match practice. Kevin Ratcliffe is still captain, as he was when Everton last won the Cup in 1984. Then Dave Watson, a former Liverpool reserve player. Martin Keown, who was brought in on Sunday to give some extra defensive cover, that was a move that worked for Howard Kendall. Then Pat Nevin, we should describe him now of penalty claim fame, I think. Neil McDonald is at number eight tonight, with Stuart McCall dropped from the Everton midfield. Graham Sharp in his testimonial year at Goodison Park. And a place alongside Sharp for Mike Newell as a second out-and-out striker. John Everill, who was left back on Sunday, is in his preferred midfield role tonight. The substitutes are McCall and Tony Cotty. As for Liverpool, Bruce Grobbelaar, of course, his 10th season as a Liverpool regular. Then Glenn Hussein, the captain in the absence of Alan Hansen and Ronnie Whelan. David Burrows plays his last game before suspension. Steve Nicol, who showed his versatility again on Sunday in that reshuffle after Steve McMahon's injury. Jan Molby, who nearly left for Barcelona last year. Liverpool very glad that they were able to hang on to him. Gary Ablett, the only Scouser in the Liverpool lineup tonight. And Peter Beardsley is recalled for his first start for Liverpool since December the 15th. Steve Staunton, left back for the Republic of Ireland, but in midfield for Liverpool. Ian Rush, so often the executioner of Everton. John Barnes, who's played in FA Cup finals against Everton for Watford as well as for Liverpool. And Barry Venison, the substitute for Steve McMahon on Sunday. He takes over McMahon's shirt tonight. So David Speedy, on his 31st birthday, is relegated to the bench. And Ray Houghton is there as well. He's been out since the replay in the third round of the FA Cup. Fascinating and passionate. It's sure to start at a helter-skelter pace. Liverpool kick-off. Good conditions underfoot. Good conditions for spectating as well. They've escaped the worst of the winter up here. It's almost like the Gulf Stream. Beardsley goes for his first header. Here's Venison wearing 11, but slotting in at right back. And Sharp letting Hussein know that he's around again. Graham Sharp started the match magnificently at Anfield. He really set the tone and the example for some of his less experienced colleagues.
First surprise, just looking at the Liverpool lineup early on, Martin, is that David Burrows, who occupied the left back spot normally, is actually playing in midfield alongside Jan Molby, and Steve Staunton has been preferred at left back. So that's the first real change that Liverpool have made.
And you think back to Liverpool's win away to Tottenham earlier in the season in the league, when Burrows did that marking job on Paul Gascoigne so successfully.
And also contributed to making a couple of goals.
Here's Abril across the face of the Liverpool goal here.
It's probably come just a little bit early in the game for John Abril, but he does the right thing in trying to go across the face of the goal, and Pat Nevin isn't too far away.
Staunton. Walsh was fouled from behind. It's hard to think that Ian Rush was an Everton supporter as a boy. He's treated his boyhood favourites so severely since he's been a Liverpool player. 23 goals in 27 Merseyside derbies. McDonald trying to link up with Nevin. How will Liverpool cope here without the real heartbeat of their midfield in both Whelan and McMahon? Rush taken twice, with Ratcliffe right behind, a man he regards very much as his friend off the pitch, but certainly not in the context of this match.
That's what they can do though, Everton. They can do that with Ian Rush and Peter Beardsley. We're having the safety valve of Martin Keown as sweeper. They can get as tight as they like, Martin, and I'm sure they will get as tight as they like. You mentioned Ian Rush's wonderful record against Everton, and I think that's part of the reason that Howard Kendall has chosen to play a sweeper in the two games, and the fact that Rush has plundered many, many goals just by his ability to break the flat back four that Everton usually employ.
Barnes, Staunton, it runs on for Beardsley, a shooting chance, oh, and Rush is there, and Southall has stopped him adding to his list. A lovely dummy by Sharp. Ray Atterveld raiding on the right. Hussein Grobbelaar started to come and could have been embarrassed. Nevin away by Ablett. If this is a sign of things to come, we are in for a rare treat. Liverpool nearly scoring, Everton hitting back, Barnes on the ball. We haven't had an opportunity to have another look at the Southall stop from Rush. We must bide our time as the players who went through 90 minutes without producing a goal on Sunday are striking at the goal right from the off here. Staunton drives it in. Steve Nicol coming in for Liverpool. Well, Peter Beardsley looked like a man with a point to prove.
He's always dangerous in this position, Martin. He's always looking to shoot. I'm very surprised that Neville Southall hasn't collected it first time. But he shows what a good goalkeeper he is. Look how quickly he's up. And that's a magnificent block when Ian Rush, I'm sure, thought he was adding to this wonderful tally of his.
It was one that got away from Ian Rush. Barnes. Burrows suddenly deviated from his central midfield position to go back on the left-hand side, and he earned Liverpool this free kick by taking Everton by surprise. Mulby takes it. That was Kevin Ratcliffe climbing well. It would have been a blow in the solar plexus if Everton had conceded a goal to Ian Rush so early in the game. They might have had a familiar sinking feeling, but Southall stopped that and kept the spirits high as a result. Rush waits for the next opportunity. Beardsley clips it towards Barnes at the near post, Sharp behind him. Oh, that's a marvellous back heel by Beardsley. This is Burrows. Any sort of touch there might have helped Liverpool. Just 11 days ago, David Burrows swung one in towards goal, and David Speedy, you might remember, touched it in the league win at Anfield.
But it's been an impressive start from Liverpool. the best way to stop a team attacking you and put them under pressure, that's to attack them. And that's certainly what Liverpool have done in the opening moments. They've taken the game to Everton and have certainly put them under some pressure.
Sharp. Buffeted by Hussein. Free kick to Everton. Played wide by McDonald. Crossed in by Atterveld. Martin Keown mixing it up in there. Sharp. Passes it back for Newell.
This was a chance for it. It arose from a long ball into the box. And that's what Everton, I'm sure, will try to do and make sure Liverpool don't clear it.
That's good play from Newell. Hinchcliffe with two to aim for. Sharp gets there. And Newell looks to go down. And I must say, I think if I was Howard Kendall, after what happened on Sunday, I'd be encouraging my players to make the most of any contact in the Liverpool penalty area.
Well, certainly yes, but I do feel that the ball was just too far out of Mike Newell's reach. I don't think he had any chance of getting the ball. It was straight through to Bruce Grobbelaar, and I think the referee did take that into consideration.
It's an Atterveld free kick. It's a Grobbelaar catch.
You watch it again, it's another cross ball, and Graham Sharp gets up magnificently well. There's certainly some contact there, Martin, but I do feel sure the fact that it was going through to the goalkeeper influenced the referee. But you're quite right, Howard Kendall, I'm sure, would have been emphasising the fact any contact at all, make the most of it.
Venison. Nicol. Everton trying to stop Liverpool settling to their passing game. For their part to get the ball up to Newell and Sharp and work it from there. Ian Rush was a little late as the ball was worked forward, which is why Neil Midgley has pulled play back for this free kick. Hussein. The winners go to West Ham in the quarter-final. Newell. And Nevin getting free. Only Hinchcliffe really available, but they're lining up in the centre. Sharp. Well, it might have gone in directly, it might have been touched in by Nevin, but neither thing happened for Everton.
But it's a wonderful knockback from Graham Sharp, and John Ebro will be disappointed that he hasn't at least made Bruce Grobbelaar make a save.
Ratcliffe. Well, there wasn't much help for Sharp. And I can tell you that Kevin Ratcliffe was being teased by Andy Gray for his forward surges on Sunday. There aren't too many of them these days, and maybe that crossed his mind because he certainly could have gone on further forward a moment or two ago. Oh, well hit by Nevin. And Grobbelaar in some difficulties by his left-hand post.
Yeah, it's the aerial problem again for Liverpool, but what a great strike from Pat Nevin. And a good save, good goalkeeping, getting his body behind it, Bruce Grobbelaar, not taking any chances.
The header by Keown, back by Burrows, in goes Rush. Venison, holding off Newell. And Atterveld had to make sure, with so much pace on the cross, that he got it further away from the goal and not back towards Southall. He's done it at the expense of a Liverpool corner that's already been taken. Barnes. Oh, Rush! It hit Ebrill. And that's an over-exuberant attempt by Watson to get there first. Well, Well, it's been half an hour without a goal, but only just.
Half an hour without a breather, either.
Burrows.
Well, we'll get one now. I've been waiting for someone to try and put their foot on the ball, Martin, and maybe have a little breather, but both sets of players are just playing the game at a frenetic pace at the moment.
Steve Staunton, who let fly then, and one would expect a better effort from a player who definitely has an eye for goal on the left foot. Beardsley. Rush. Barnes. The net shakes, but the ball hit it on the outside.
Well, it's his wonderful first touch that gives him the opportunity. Kills it dead. But he goes narrow side, and I'd have been very surprised if he'd have beat a goalkeeper of South Wales class on the near side.
Free kick given to Everton. Another chance to send the big players forward from the back to support Newell and Sharp in the air. Keown will be there. Watson as well. This is where Everton might feel that they can tilt the tie their way. Hinchcliffe. Watson trying to force a way through. Newell couldn't get round the outside. Played forward by Staunton. Oh, and Rush has got the better of Ratcliffe. Ian Rush takes on Neville Southall. And off the line by Hinchcliffe. Beardsley. Everton thought they'd escaped, but they hadn't. Ian Rush with the chance really to feast at his favourite table, but he didn't collect the goal. Hinchcliffe did wonderfully well, but it was ran back by Beardsley, and there was nothing that Southall or indeed Hinchcliffe could do to deny the follow-up. Yes, Noah Kenwell probably more reflecting on how his team went a goal behind. Newell, Hinchcliffe, Keown, Watson. No one could master the bounce. And Barnes out tackles Nevin. And Beardsley goes through the middle. Oh, and Southall might have been beaten. It could have been off Anderville with Beardsley sliding in. The goalkeeper had come out, he thought, to help clear the danger, and he almost added to it. McDonald. Nicol helped out behind Gunnison there.
I think what happened in the Southall case there was he thought he was that Peter Beardsley was going to do it for pace and was coming out to help. But Ray Attaboy was saying to him, well, I had perfectly in control there and I was just trying to knock it back to you in the area. I mean, it's a super ball from John Barnes, and Peter Beardsley makes a great run inside Ray Attaboy, but he's always in control. And Neville just comes into no man's land a bit there. And that could have been very embarrassing.
In those situations, you always need a good distance between the two teammates. The closer they get, the less the margin for error is. It was very, very tight for those two then. And it wasn't really Attaboy's fault. Barnes. Venison. Here's Nicol. Liverpool looking for number two.
They haven't got it, the flag is up. Even before Southport made that miraculous stop from Barnes, the linesman was flagging.
Yeah, the linesman may have been flagging, Martin, but Neville Southall wouldn't have known this. He's, in fact, there may be level there. The new rule may have come into play there, but what a wonderful save from the goalkeeper.
And although they've had their luck in their FA Cup run so far, they deserve their lead at half-time here, provided for them in the end by Peter Beardsley. But the key moment, really, from the Everton point of view, when Kevin Ratcliffe, who 99 times out of 100 would have dealt with the danger against Ian Rush, lost out. And although for once against Everton Rush wasn't the scorer, Beardsley took the goal. And the second half will be a story here of whether Everton can come back from that.
Home again. Children, pets, guests. In no time, your carpet looks filthy.
The proof? Feels bad, doesn't it?
Well, now new Vanish Power Foam makes carpet cleaning fast and effective without a soaking wet carpet.
Simply spray on, work in, and vacuum off. Look at the difference.
Wow, that's fantastic.
Whether it's the living room, hallway, or stairs,
new Vanish Power Foam is the easy way to bring the high traffic areas of your carpets back to life.
Vanish. Trust pink, forget stains.
Let the games begin!
The motion picture event of the year.
We are going to spank you!
Where revenge is best served. Ice Cold Beer Fest.
Everyone has their own way of doing things. Like for some people, the most important thing in life is to always be in touch with the people they have fun with. It's for these people that we've created Dolphin, a great new talk package, including unlimited texts. Orange, the future's bright.
Every day, the Mail is offering another DVD of David Attenborough's greatest wildlife documentaries. Pick up The Life of Birds free with tomorrow's Daily Mail.
Dad?
Yes, love?
Can you help me with my maths?
You, Max, that's a good one.
Ask your mother.
She's out.
She's gone out? What are you going to do now?
Why don't you use a calculator?
That's cheating.
Bad dad. Very bad dad.
Dad, I need to do it now.
Get rid of your gremlins and get on. Call 0800 66 0800.
Come out with a substitute on. Stuart McCall replaces Ray Atterveld. Liverpool a goal up as Everton start the second half. It's been such an era of Merseyside derbies in Liverpool's favour since Kenny Dalglish came here as a player in 1977. 41 derbies in that time, and Everton have won only 9 of them. to 21 Liverpool wins. And the only time, really, when Everton held some sway, of course, was when Howard Kendall was manager here the first time. And he's trying to get it back to those levels again.
I actually think I might have played in a couple of those derby wins as well, Martin. Strange there.
McDonald, who's got very good feet, as they say, in the football trade. He got into shooting positions on Sunday two or three times, didn't always hit them as well as he would have liked.
No, he hits it very well. It's a difficult angle. I think Bruce is quite happy to see that one, that attempted shot from there. I'd be surprised if he could beat him. But I'm not surprised that Howard Kendall's decided to change and bring on Stuart McCall. I felt that they had got the ball into the box quite well at times. What they hadn't done is got the support players up with them. And I think someone that can get in there and has proved in the past that he'll get in there is Stuart McCall.
Sharp wins a header for the benefit of Nevin. It's McDonald who crosses. Newell poised at the far post. And Nicol is limping. Sharp! It went through Grobbelaar. Less than 2 minutes gone in the second half. Everton fists are raised now, and as Graham Sharp redresses the balance.
It's a great cross in, but no one really picks up Graham Sharp. He gets behind Gary Ablett and puts in a fine header.
Nevin sticks over Staunton. Newell and Sharp in the centre, joined by Everett. Nevin goes his own way. McCall made it his when it wasn't. Pat Nevin can put them in front and hasn't, and wonders how he didn't.
Well, it's another defensive error, this time from Liverpool. Players getting involved, and Pat Nevin had never ever been a chance to put Everton. You see what he tried to do. I remember him scoring a very similar goal here at Goodison against Manchester United when he went through on Jim Leighton, it was at the time, and just tried to flick it over him. He just gets flat a little bit too much on it and doesn't threaten the goal.
Rush. Here's Watson. Everything that's 50-50 at the moment going to Everton. Newell making Hussein go all the way back to the edge of his own area. That's ricocheted off Nicol, who was just got away. Staunton. Benison. Liverpool having to look to their laurels. Oh, and Rush has pounced on another mistake by Keown this time. But there isn't the same impetus about Liverpool to follow up on it. They can hardly catch their breath at the moment, the way Everton have started the second half. Sharp, very much to the fore.
It's been a great substitution, Mark. Not only does Stuart McCall get forward, but what he has done as well, he's attached himself to Jan Molby, who really had been pulling the strings for Liverpool in that late part of the first half. And now Molby's finding it difficult to shake a free of him.
Oh, it's done by Watson. It's Newell! Well, when bodies start to dip and fly like that, you expect them to end up in the net.
Well, this could end up anywhere. It's a wonderful strike from him. And just how close does it go?
Oh, that close. Well, this couldn't hang with it. There's another aspect to the substitution as well, in with Neil McDonald at right back, who's such a good crosser of the ball, with no disrespect to Ray Atterbell. There will be an improvement, one would think, in the service as well, because McDonald has been moved out of the middle of midfield to accommodate McCall. Yes, Hussein. And they're furious on the Liverpool bench with that decision. Hussein isn't particularly pleased either. Sure that he'll get a a side of this if it really flies. McDonald takes it, and he did see it. And luckily for the Liverpool goalkeeper, it wasn't deflected, I don't think. Although there were a lot of players close to the path of the shot. He's going to make anything, it's got to be for himself. The others are all concentrating on defending. Now Vance has to think about that as well, and an Everton free kick. Head. They can take a short one if they want here, Everton. But maybe better advised just to prey on this Liverpool uncertainty at the moment in the box. Grobbelaar can't get there sharp, and Grobbelaar came through the crowd, back from the call. The whistle has gone, and I apologise for not hearing it.
But again, you see the problems that it's causing, the aerial bombardment. There's a lot of bodies got for that. I mean, I'm not so sure if there's any infringement there.
Mulvey. He's a good barometer, really, for how the game is shaping, Mulvey. Able to pass it well, Liverpool are starting to get on top. Here he is. He's found Nicol, despite the attentions of McCall. He's more like Liverpool in the first half. Beardsley, Barnes is free. Oh! They're not only back on top, they're back in front. And it's a bonanza here for Peter Beardsley.
Well, what an incredible strike from Beardsley. He just drags it away to create the space with his right foot.
Disasters for Liverpool. Hussein going down, Grobbelaar way out of home, and Nicol couldn't repair the damage. Barnes. Rush joined by Beardsley in the middle as Barnes takes on Watson. Oh, Southall's pushing away back from one of his own players, Keown. There was no attempt to get there first. Opponent. Mulvey, where are Everton to close him down? Rush! The scourge strikes at Everton again. The merest of flicks, but it was his.
I didn't think we'd seen the last of the scoring, but we were ever thinking about defensively. And this is a good header from Ian Rush. Plenty of blue shots in there. If you look round, he's absolutely surrounded by blue shots.
And 3-3 is not out of the question.
But that is the question. And how many times are they going to be asked to come back and manage to do it? For the third time of asking now.
of Steve Staunton's head. And you won't get much nearer to 3-3 than that without it actually happening. By Barnes. Rush. This is Burrows. Barnes getting up with him. Burrows faced by Ratcliffe. Rush. Beardsley is on a hat trick. Push by Hussein. Everton won't have that many more chances to draw level for a third time. They're withdrawing Nevin, hoping that Tony Cotty, who would love to contribute to setting up a quarter-final trip to his old club West Ham, but there's a fair bit to do. McDonald, and it pumps into Grovelaar's chest. Well, we often ask players to be super cool, super professional. There are times when it's impossible, and I think this match is an emotional experience as much as a physical one for them. It's certainly emotional sitting here. Then well, Sharp trying to locate McDonald. Everall. 3 minutes left on the watch. Three goals in the bank for Liverpool. Two in reply for Everton. The difference on the benches now. Sharp, he hardly deserves to be a loser. Oh, Ratcliffe's fallen. There's little cover on at the back if Liverpool can move it forward quickly. And there's a spare man on this near side who is Peter Beardsley, and still might involve Mulvey, just nudging it. Barnes. Liverpool engaged in using up time. Barnes goes on. I think Ratcliffe was delighted he didn't make contact then. Feeling the strain.
Well, it really has been a pleasure to sit and watch this game tonight. And both teams, tremendous amount of credit. What can one say about Liverpool? They haven't enjoyed a lion's share of the play in the second half, but they've managed to produce two very, very good goals and lead 3-2. Everton been asked just to do too much to come back from the third time, but we'll certainly feel that they should have taken something from the game.
To the last minute. McDonald. McCall helps it in. Cotty! 3-3! The substitution succeeds. Well, with rare drama.
I can't believe, but what cool finishing! Not on his strongest side, You did say he would love to go back to West Ham. And what a time to produce a goal. Just when you felt that was it. Liverpool were through to the next round. Certainly one of the best games I've ever had the privilege of sitting watching, Martin.
Tony Cottee has taken us to the very brink of extra time. But Rush... well, I don't think we would have believed it.
If he'd have swung round and put that one in, I think he'd have found me flat in my back here, Martin. He'd have had to revive me. That would have been unbelievable.
Cottee has stretched credulity almost to breaking point. It's extra time at Goodison Park. Well, the word great is often overused, but this has surely been a great 90 minutes. And we're going to get another 30 minutes because of this.
And you look how far it travels. I mean, Gary Ablett just gets caught there. I mean, I'm not sure whether you could put any blame to him, but it was a hopeful ball through from Stuart McCall rather than a meaningful one. But that little man came on fresh, eager, and hasn't he take it very, very well.
September means vintage footy on ESPN Classic. Remember when the Premiership was still the first division? Let's gear up for another exciting new season, bringing you blockbusting action from five top clubs. Liverpool.
Birkin.
Arsenal.
He's got some space.
Have a shot. Oh.
Tottenham Hotspur.
What a goal.
And Aston Villa.
Win. The ball back in front.
We're gonna get ya. Saturday at 6 on ESPN Classic. Dead good sport.
Sharp for Everton, Beardsley for Liverpool, Sharp for Everton, Rush for Liverpool, Cottee for Everton, and on we go.
What I just wondered at the start of extra time, Martin, that throwing on Tony Cottee was obviously a gamble. They had the problem now of having three out-and-out strikers, and it is noticeable that they've dropped Mike Newell back into the midfield area, so Howard Kendall, not that silly to take the chance this early on in throwing three up front.
But Newell has made his way forward at the moment, hoping a cross might come in towards him, which it does. He's jumping with Nicol. Oh, and it's Cottee again. 31 seconds on my watch into the first period of extra time.
Well, there's no doubt this tactic has caused Liverpool problems tonight in dealing with it. It's a great leap from Mike Newell.
Barnes, who does look very fresh. And it's the sort of ball that Lee Sharp put in to embarrass the Norwich defender John Polston on Monday, which led to Brian McClair's equaliser for Manchester United. An awkward bounce. Everton survived on this occasion, but it's a Liverpool corner.
Ominous signs for Everton, though. John Barnes, as you say, seems to have come to life in extra time, Martin.
Mulvey. Rush with another header and a wonderful save corner taken. Assessment in a moment. Nicol. McDonald. Ian Rush got to terrific power into the header because there wasn't that much on the ball as it reached him. The spring Southall showed. You could go as far as to say that it's the best spell Barnes has had in the match. Knew that Hinchcliffe had got the ball past him. Coming up to 7 minutes played in the first period of extra time. Everton 3, Liverpool 3. Hinchcliffe. Well, the crowd noise told you everything there. Let's have a look at the Southall save first.
You did say that this is something that Ian Rush has improved, his heading ability, and this proves it. That's a wonderful header.
Ablett. Barnes. Free kick to Liverpool. 3 minutes to go to half-time in extra time.
He certainly looked the brightest player on the park in this period, apart from that man we just seen, Neville Southall, who's had to be tremendously alert to produce two stunning saves.
Barnes, it looks for goal! And finds it! For a fourth time, Neville Southall has to pick the ball out. Keogh. That's Newell holding it up. Oh, and there's confusion again. Grobbelaar came and laid out Staunton. He's got to come again and he's got the ball this time. Staunton's recovered his senses. Grobbelaar's recovered the ball.
It's been one of those nights for Bruce, hasn't it? Again, I mean, I've got some sympathy with Steve Staunton because it's there to be headed.
Well, Liverpool, a mixture of marvellous play and defensive mayhem.
If I've said it once, I've said it a million times tonight. It's that aerial ball that they haven't coped with.
He really believed that might happen when you see things like this. Some great control by Grobbelaar and by Staunton. It's outrageous. It's not from the coaching manual. And Liverpool, who just got past Blackburn, were nearly knocked out by Brighton. And they're still leading against Everton, but only just. Offside. You start to think of football cliches like if your name is on the cup, don't you, in these circumstances? After what Liverpool have been through.
There's been plenty of signs of that so far this season for that man, isn't there? And he would be not excused for thinking that.
11 minutes to go. Liverpool regroup, wanting to keep as much together as a unit as they can, as Everton will let them. Newell gets in first, well, for his side. And Sharp, the support is there from Cotty. And turn from McDonald. Newell on the far side. McCall trying to drive ahead of the ball from midfield to reach the knockdown. Hinchcliffe did very well. Oh, and Hussain is back on the cross. They're back from the net again. For Beardsley, but not to Rush. The Evertonians want a winner. They're not fully satisfied with the recovery, although they are so thrilled by it. Sharp. The header forward by Newell. Sharp. Two goals for him tonight, two for Cotty. Robillard comes. Oh, he's lost it! And Cotty very nearly given his dream tie at Upton Park.
Well, Bruce is there again, under a little bit of pressure, but takes his eye off it. And just for a second, Tony Cotty must have thought a hat trick was beckoning.
The next game would be here at Goodison Park. They've already tossed for that, and that's what we get. Fabulous, phenomenal. Those are the sort of words that come to mind. John Bart. And Everton got up to the slope, and they finally.
On ESPN Classic. Remember when the championship was still the first division? Let's gear up for another exciting new season, bringing you blockbusting action from five top clubs. Liverpool.
Yes, that's it.
Everton.
And that's Lineker's hat-trick.
Birkin. Arsenal. He's got space.
Tottenham Hotspur. So, let's choose some topping. Tonight at 9 on ESPN Classic. Dead good sport.
Good dog, Fido. Oh, there you are. Just taking the dog for a stroll. Needs must and all. It's Sunday and it's all about football.
With selected Vio laptops from only $5.96. Laptop, like the new Skype mouse for calls via the web. One Vio rucksack.
Until you're in work and earning over $15,000. And even then, you could be paying just $15,000 more.
Sunshade. Nobody knows what it's all about. It's too much that I all hang.
On DVD, Star Wars, A New Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi. Each two-disc set also includes the original cinema version. The Star Wars Trilogy on DVD Monday.
Nina, the new magical fragrance by Nina Ricci.
If you hurry, you can get 0% finance over 4 years on nearly every model in the Renault range. As we said, nearly every model in the Renault range.
Brian? Bob? Bit overdressed, aren't they? I'm just sorting out my car insurance. Well, I call the AA team. They search over 20 insurance companies to find me their best quote.
OK, 40% less with a full money-back guarantee if you find a cheaper quote.
Not bad.
Give us a call.
To find out if you could save up to 40%, call the AA team. Here to get you a better deal.
This is not just any fighter.
Everybody who ever saw him said he was the best.
There's Ray Robinson, and then there's the top 10. Sugar, sugar
on sweet as you. Hear from those in the know about the man they call pound for pound the greatest boxer of all time.
Sugar Ray Robinson.
Find yourself ringside. Sugar Ray Robinson. Tonight at midnight.
Hello, you're watching ESPN Classic, the Dead Good Sports Channel. So what does that mean exactly, apart from a large fee for the marketing consultants who came up with the slogan? Obviously, well, being dead isn't a prerequisite of getting onto the schedule, but being good is. And given the size of the archive we've got access to, the qualifying standard is pretty high.
Roma at home, so my recollection would be that we never felt we were favourites. We thought it was going to be the toughest of all. I mean, you know, European Cup final, you expect to play on a neutral ground, don't you? You don't expect to play the people who play there every week or so every other week. So, no, I think we felt that we were certainly underdogs.
I think it was the wrong place to have played the game, simply because it was their home ground. To go there, obviously, there's probably a lot more pressure on them than what there was on us, because they were the home side and they did the majority of the support there, and their supporters turned up in us again. They're still in the minority, but we're feeling inferior in any way, shape or form. And we just got on with it as best we possibly could.
I remember the week before we went to Israel. We always used to go to Israel end of the season. And we went and just played a game there and just had a bit of sort of R&R, as it were, a few beers, but we trained and stuff. And I remember the Monday before the final, we were playing a five-a-side at Melwood and everything. And Joe was the manager, wasn't he, Joe Fagan and stuff. And I remember him just turning to Ronnie Moran saying, "Crikey, you're going to have to hold these buggers back," which is exactly what he said. So I think that was tantamount to saying, "They're ready." And it turned out we were. It's a strange thing going to the European Cup final anyway, and it's like anything, we always used to get there too early for me. And I just remember turning up at the ground, probably 70% of the ground was full, and this was 2 hours before the match and stuff, and there was a kids game on the pitch, and one thing or another. We got in the dressing room, Ronnie Ramon said, "He'll clear off on the pitch, get out of our way, we need to put the kit out." So we all sort of filed down the stairs, walked onto, well, the pitch surrounds, because there was a game on, and Graham Sinessa, who was the captain, sort of went, "Let's walk all the way around and wind them up." And we sort of thought, Are you sure about this? He went, yeah, okay. So we walked all the way around him, like chucking stuff at us, booing and everything. And as we were walking off to go back to the dressing room, and bear in mind that the dressing rooms at Rome at the time, Olympic Stadium, in the corner, and you had to sort of walk up some stairs to our dressing room, single file. And we were all massive Chris Rea fans. And I think Davey Hodgson had been at Middlesbrough, Graham Sinnes, Craig Johnson, those kind of lads, and they all knew the words of the songs and stuff like that. And somebody just started singing. I don't know what it is, but I love it. That's all. We presume that was the title. It probably even wasn't, right? So fine. And so we're sort of, you imagine this scenario. We're all sort of going up the stairs towards the dressing room, and unbeknown to us, we pass the Roma dressing room, get into our dressing room, finish the song, really loud, sort of all bored. Naughty schoolboys on tour.
I don't know why it came about. We were just waiting to go on the pitch, and I think they kept us waiting a little bit. And somebody started singing it, so everybody else joined in, and they must have wondered what was happening when they walked out.
And then Nils Lidholm, who was the manager, the Swedish manager of Roma, he just then said in the press conference after the match, he said, I knew my team were beaten, he said, because he said Liverpool was singing before the match. And he said, I'm in the dressing room giving my team talk to the players. He said, you know, we're under pressure, we're at home, maybe people expect us to win, that kind of stuff. And he said, I just heard this singing. He said, it got louder and louder and louder. And he said, my players, he said, they went whiter and whiter and whiter. And he said, I didn't say anything at the time. I just thought to myself, oh, we're in trouble. And he was right.
Roma in white kickoff, and there's a great test for Bruce Grobbelaar straight away. Falcao hitting him with a long, long ball. Liverpool, who've won every away tie in Europe this season, and come here with great confidence, having shared the hotel with them the last couple of days. There's a great air.